So if you're in the market for a budget wireless microphone setup, a lavalier mic, you've come to the right place because I'm going to show you a couple of wired and wireless options. The first one is going to be the Holyland Lark M2. I'm going to use that kind of as the basis for this video. If I lean back, you can see it's on my chest. It's about the size of maybe a suit jacket button, something that's easy to conceal. It can be magnetically applied with a magnet behind the fabric like I've got here, or you can also use a clip. Now, the nice thing with this one is it comes with different stickers. Normally, as you can see in the photos, it has the Holyland logo on it for the Lark M2. So even though it's small, it's kind of in your face a bit. So if you wear like a lot of black t-shirts or clothing like I do, or just want to conceal it behind something, it actually comes with stickers that you can use to conceal it better, or on the flip side, if you want to actually make it more prominent and expose it and kind of own it with smiley faces and various other things, it has that too. So the container that it comes in, it's kind of like an AirPods type setup where it's got the receiver, which in my case is USB-C. There's also a lightning one, and there's two microphones. So if you're doing podcasting, for example, or interviews, you can have each person wear one. You can hear what it sounds like now indoors in a relatively well-treated room in terms of, you know, soundboards. I've got furniture in here and carpet, so it doesn't sound too echoey, but it sounds, I think, pretty neutral in terms of a microphone. Now this base charges it, and you can see once it's charging, there's actually indicator lights. I've got 3 dots here out of 4 in this case. It's around 70-75% charged, but the microphones in the case itself last for several hours. I've probably been using this without having to recharge it maybe for a total of 10 or so hours for the one microphone I tend to use. But when you put it back in the case, it recharges it. The receiver itself is powered via the USB bus that it plugs into. The receiver will work. It says Android in the Amazon listing, but it will also work on things like iOS and Mac and Linux, whatever will take a USB-C input as a microphone. So that one we're comparing, that's kind of the main one for this video, but I also want to compare it against two different budget options on the wired and wireless side. So from a wired perspective, it was a tip that I got in the beginning of the pandemic for something called the PowerDewise wired lavalier mic. Now the cool thing with this mic is it goes for about $22 right now. It's on a radical discount right now on Amazon, normally I think $50. So it doesn't quite have the same flexibility of a wireless microphone, but it's pretty good. It's $22. So then the other one that I'm going to try out is the Lonzi J12, which there's a bunch of these kind of budget microphones that I suspect these wireless ones have more or less the same kind of low-cost internals. There's other ones from like Boya, Ulanzi, other ones that are actually the same housings that are kind of marked the same. They charge in a similar type of case, you know, like the AirPods style design with the two microphones, it comes with two as well. And the receiver, the device that plugs into your phone or your laptop, that can also be USB-C or Lightning depending on the option that you get. For $50, I think it's a pretty good option. It's gonna sound better than a phone, especially if that phone is far away while you're recording things like TikTok videos or social media posts, etc. The next one I'm gonna try out then is the Shure MBL, which is a little bit more on the professional side, wired lavalier mic. I think you would normally use it with like a Shure UHF type belt pack. That one goes for about $70, so it's not quite like my favorite lavalier mic. My favorite one that I use in my day job at work every day is a Sanken COS-11D. Those go for the $500 to $800 range, depending on the options that you get, but they're magnitudes more expensive. They're even more expensive than things like the dynamic microphones I like to use at home, like an SM7B, or I've got a MV7 behind me that's kind of in the under $300 range. So we're going to compare what the Holyland sounds like that you're hearing right now. And we're also going to compare the sound of the other microphones just so you can hear those too. Okay, so just to get started, I'll be using this kind of as a palate cleanser and kind of to get through the entire set of microphones that I want to test. So let's try out now the lowest cost one that you may like. It's the PowerDewise. All right, so this is the PowerDewise, the lowest cost option. It's about $22 on Amazon right now, normally $50, just so you can hear what it sounds like, normal talking voice. It's in the same position as the Hollyland Lark M2. After I watched this the first time, I was kind of blown away by the bass tones and the depth that it has in terms of that presence. It sounds more radio podcasty, dynamic mic-y, if that's a term, than kind of the more, lavalier sounding ones that tend to be a bit thinner sounding. It is a little bit more sensitive in terms of some of the other microphones. Not sensitive in the sense that it hears you breathe as much, which I think you could hear with the Hollyland Lark M2, because that's really picking up on those breath tones and, that higher end of the sound spectrum. But this one, if I blow down, or if I do proximity, which is basically like, say, I was doing a demo or something, looking down, you can really hear the difference with it, and it gets a bit bassier and more proximity. But if you're always looking out, maybe at a teleprompter or presenting to your screen and always looking up, this one sounds pretty good. The one thing I would say is you don't want to touch it. So if I kind of just barely bang it a little bit, you're going to hear that and it's going to be terrible. I apologize for that. But I think the sound profile of this one, again, PowerDawise, never heard of the company. It was a tip that I got from a friend. It sounds kind of dodgy, but I paid for all these mics with my own money. I got this in the early days of the pandemic. And it sounds pretty darn good, in my opinion, especially for its $22 price point and all the extras that comes with the cabling and everything else. So let's go back to the Hollyland Lark M2 to hear what that sounds like as a palate cleanser, and then we're going to try out our next mic. And just listening back to the PowerDawise, I got to say I really love the tonality of that device. For $22, you can't really go wrong. As you can tell, though, it's pretty sensitive if you blow on it or if you tap it with your hand, so do not touch it once it's in position. But to me, it sounds almost like a dynamic mic, even though it's a condenser, kind of like the Senkin that I like. It's got more of that kind of radio podcast sound to it, despite it being a lav mic. Okay, so now let's have a look at the Ulanzi, and this again was a palate cleanser. I'm back on the Hollyland Lark M2. Okay, so this one that you're hearing right now is the Ulanzi J12. It has also a wireless USB receiver. It's USB-C, so it works on newer iOS, iPhone, iPad devices, Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, obviously, like it says of the postings. You can get them in Lightning, but I don't see the point much anymore unless you've got an older iPhone. But this is what it sounds like. I've done a whole video on this one, by the way. You can check out the link on the screen. I think it sounds a little bit kind of compressed or modified or processed to me. I'm not a huge fan of the way this one sounds, especially after I heard the last one, the PowerDawise, for half the price of this one. Yes, you do need a wire, but that one I think had a good sound profile to it. Okay, back on the Hollyland Lark M2, that was the Ulanzi. To me, that one sounds a little bit like there's some compression, noise suppression, tunnel-like sound. I think it's trying to reduce the bandwidth or something of maybe the radio frequencies it's sending compared to some of the 2.4 gigahertz or some of the UHF-style microphones that tend to really sound crisp and have a lot of definition and fidelity. So again, I'm on the Hollyland Lark M2 just for a little bit of a palate cleanser. Let's move on to the Shure MVL that goes for about $70 on Amazon. Okay, so this is the Shure MVL microphone that you're hearing right now. It's about a $69 or $70 microphone that you can get at the moment. To me, having listened to this and kind of done a few tries at this one, it sounds a little bit thin, if I'm honest, in terms of microphones. You can EQ it out a little bit, but it has that classic kind of lav mic sound that probably requires a little bit of processing. It's very much focused on the human vocal range, so I'm guessing if you bump a table or do any of those kind of things, it's not going to hear that, because it's probably a nice roll off at the bottom end. But this is the Shure MVL. This is the most professional one, probably the highest cost, at least lav mic, that I owned. Let's see if I bang it a little bit, if it sounds any different. And I'm going to try proximity and kind of point my mouth down and then point my mouth back up. Again, Shure MVL, $69 microphone on Amazon. My all-up opinion now, listening to everything and kind of hearing what it sounds like, I do recommend the Hollyland Lark M2, just pure for its size and flexibility and what comes in the package and the fact that there's two microphones. It's USB-C, so it works with basically any device these days. As a USB mic, Hopefully this helps and saves you some time, saves you some money. If you liked the video, be sure to give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you so much for watching.